as often as possible. This is in the discretion of the referee, who is in sole charge. Round one getting underway. Snapped in Rodrigo Valdez in the lemon trunk, and the challenger, who keeps his gloves up high, Ramon Mendez from Santa Fe, Argentina.
Valdez is also a very slow starter here, and I think if you'll look around and try to pitch shots on the man to start out, you'll see exactly what Mendez is going to do.
Valdez could be a deceiving fighter, Ken. He realizes that everybody thinks he's a slow starter. He may change that and open up in a hurry. Valdez has all the equipment, a good jab, a good hook, a classic right hand. The challenger's done most of the fighting so far, however, and those left hooks were hard. The referee from Colombia, Humberto Caceres. You'll notice that the challenger is working the body. Both men are 28 years old. Valdez is 3 inches taller at 5'10".
Also, Valdez is known for his punching power, and he's able to take an individual out with just one shot, whereas his opponent usually goes into combination.
So far, the attack has been sent by Mendez, with Valdez scoring that one good punch. You'll hear most of the right yelling for Valdez. Mendez has a few rooters here. He has been carrying the touch to Valdez. Valdez, who has such a good right hand, is solely using his left hook at the moment and the jab.
Also, Valdez seems to be just floating his jab out, trying to find his man, which I think is trying to set him up for a right hand.
Mendez keeps his gloves up reasonably high, protects the body with the elbow and the face with the gloves. Valdez's gloves are a little bit lower with a minute to go in round one. A solid right that time by Valdez. And that definitely bothers the challenger.
There you have a perfect example of a solid right hand shot from one shot, individual shot.
Valdez starting to open up. Those jabs hurt. Mendez ran right into that one. Over anxious is Valdez, and a solid punching by the challenger. Hooks and crosses. A very good first round here in Cali, Colombia, and the round is almost over. Only seconds to go in this round. There's the bell. Round two in Cali, Colombia, for the World Boxing Council middleweight title. The champion, Rodrigo Valdez, in the lemon trunk, is opening up and trying for a knockout. The challenger, Ramon Mendez from Argentina. They are trading, which is good for the champion. He's the puncher. Mendez is getting as much as he's taking. The boys are almost toe-to-toe, but they're fighting flat-footed. Rodriguez has been flat-footed all the way. Mendez up on his toes occasionally. Valdez has won 55 of the 61 fights with 4 losses and 2 draws. He has scored 36 knockouts and was stopped once by Rudy Escobar in 1965, and Rudy is here this afternoon.
You notice the champion Valdez is finding his man with a good jab, and there he's going with the combination of hooks, the right hand.
Mendez has been working the body more, switching occasionally that hook to the head. Jolting punching by the champion. That right hand has hurt, and there is down. Mendez is down. 4, 5, he's taken the mandatory 8 count. 7, 8. He takes the mandatory 8 count. The referee wipes off the glove. Trying for a knockout is Rodrigo Valdez. Mendez gamely trying to fight back. Mendez is still in there. He was down for the mandatory 8 count. Valdez has him in trouble. Valdez using every punch he's got. The hook, the uppercut, both hands. A minute to go on the round. 1 minute to go. That punch was partially blocked. A hard hook to the jaw by Mendez. There, he's still full of fight. This has been one of the finer fights of the year. Valdez has his man against the ropes in Valdez's corner. Mendez is a good fighter, no question about that. He's game and he can punch.
He's very game, very game.
Half a minute to go on the round. A terrific fight, and there goes Mendez down for the second time. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He's in trouble, he's wobbling. 9. Is he going to let him continue? Yes, he is. We've got 10 seconds to go on the round. A man cannot be saved by the bell. Mendez fighting back hard. There's the bell. And Mendez weathered the storm. Round 3. Let us see if the challenger game, Ramon Mendez, can survive another round. He was down twice. You cannot be saved by the bell except in the last round. If you go down and the bell rings, you must arise by the count of 10 or be counted out.
You'll also notice that that round you had an example of the awesome punching power of this man Valdez. And also, he's landing everything right on point. He's pinpointing his shots well. This is going to be a telling factor later on in the fight.
Dan, every time I see Valdez, he looks a little bit better. He keeps getting better. But I'm surprised that Mendez can stand up under that punishment and fight back, Ken.
Well, I'll tell you, it shows that this man knows he only has one chance in a life, maybe, to become the champion of the world.
I think he's on his way again, Ken. That was a solid right, and it hurt. Valdez has all the good boxing equipment. 2 minutes left in the round. He's in trouble again.
He's in trouble, but he knows he's hurt and he's covering well and he's countering on the right time.
It's too early in the bout for Valdez to punch himself out. The referee keeps getting in our way.
You notice the challenger is keeping his gloves high, trying to ward off the shots of Valdez.
Valdez could find that body wide open. He's peppering him almost at will now. Valdez in the lemon trunk, as you know. That uppercut.
Very good.
Close to doing it. He is in real trouble now. Mendez trying to bob and weave out of trouble. He's as game as they come and has landed some good punches himself. A minute to go in round 3. It's scheduled for 15.
Valdez is taking his shots well, but as you notice, he's definitely a headhunter.
Yes, Mendez's body's wide open, Ken.
Some very good shots now would be right behind the elbows, which would bring the man's gloves down, which would in turn open his head more.
I notice that Valdez is not rushing things, Ken. He's taking his time.
That's very true.
Half a minute to go in the round. 30 seconds.
He's taking his shots very well here.
It has been an amazing round for the challenger, 28 years old Ramon Mendez from Santa Fe, Argentina. He has bobbed, held, covered, and is still in there after an awesome meeting in both rounds. Time almost over here. There's the bell. Round 4 in the Coliseo del Pueblo in Cali, Colombia. The challenger, Ramon Mendez, in the black trunk, has had 54 fights, winning 47, losing 7. He's had 28 knockouts. He was stopped once himself. He has won 6 in a row. He was down twice in the second round, took a beating in the third, and I am surprised that he's still fighting. But he's a game campaigner. He knows his way around in there.
I think that Mendez now is a little warmer. I think he's going to come on stronger. He's going to press the fight more. He feels that if he stands back and lets Valdez take a shot, he can't be hurt.
How far in the bout would you think, Ken? Well, we'll hold it now. Mendez has been hurt again. 2 minutes to go on the round. That right hand almost upended him. But he's a gangster. He still fights back. I was going to say, how far into the bout would it have to go for Valdez to punch himself out?
Well, I don't think that he'll punch himself out in this fight. He's been trained by Gil Clancy, who's a very good trainer, and I think that he's in very good shape. And I feel that at the pace that he's going, that he will be able to continue the whole fight at the same pace.
We saw Foreman punch himself out against Ali, remember?
These are two different individuals.
Valdez, a very calm champion, confident, taking his time. He knows he can win this, and if he knows he doesn't win it early, he can win it late. So he's not throwing the wild ones. He is waiting for an opening to jolt and shake up this fellow again, and when he does, he'll give him the combination.
That's very true. He's stalking him in around and around the ring, taking these shots.
This has been a fast round, only a minute left.
I think that's also a negative factor on Valdez's part. Instead of setting the ring off on the man, he seems to be following him around and around the ring.
Mendez seems to be hurt again, but we've been saying that all along. Mendez short with that right lead. Half a minute to go in the round.
Mendez may be hurt, but he's very game and he's still fighting back.
It is round four, scheduled for 15. Now he's got Valdez backing up. Only seconds to go in the round. In Cali, Colombia, the sports capital of Colombia. The champion, Rodrigo Valdez, in the light trunks. They are lemon-colored. The challenger, Santa Fe's favorite son, Ramon Mendez, Santa Fe, Argentina. If you joined us late, Mendez was down twice and almost out in the second round. Took a beating in the third, did a little bit better in the fourth. We are now coming up to the one-third portion of the fight. Scheduled for 15, a crowd of almost 20,000. Roaring their approval of this good fight. For the first time, Valdez went into a dance, the Alley Shuffle.
If you notice, Valdez is getting a lot more confident now. He's starting to drop his hands a little bit. He's also taking a few more chances than he normally would. Also, his punches are very stiff, which is the first factor.
Valdez weighing 159 and a half. A half a pound under the middleweight limit, and he's got it down in trouble again. A minute and 45 seconds left to go in the round.
The crowd literally acts everything that Valdez does here. Some of those shots are good, and again, some of the shots are being watered off by the man's glove.
They even see it when he misses over the head. A good counterpuncher, Valdez. He's got all the boxing equipment. Some of that early body punishment that Valdez took in the first round could affect him later. It is very warm, particularly under these ring lights.
But you notice Valdez is still strictly head-hunting. He very seldom throws a body
shot. He ran into a shot there that did him no good. A good countering right hand by Mendez. A minute to go in the round, round five. Mendez taken up again, and he's down. Referee had to get between him. The count is about four. Six, he's taking the mandatory eight count. The mandatory eight count, that is the third time Mendez has been down in the fight. There is no three knockdown rule, by the way. And a man cannot be saved by the bell. Half a minute to go in the round. Round five.
Mendez is keeping his guard very high, trying to ward up the punches, trying to throw a punch, keep one hand up, and counter with the other hand.
I think, Ken, though, he's fighting on nerve alone at this point. He's taking a lot of punishment. Valdez is raking him. 10 seconds to go in the round. Now Valdez is working the body. Mendez still game. Round six in Cali, Colombia. Rodrigo Valdez in the lemon or light trunks doing a fine job of defending his World Council middleweight title against Ramon Mendez, a sturdy challenger who has been down three times so far, twice in the second round, once in the fifth, but he is still in there battling.
But also Mendez is a very good challenger, and the fight isn't over to the last bell, so the man is counted out. Very game, he's doing a wonderful job in there.
And as you said earlier, Ken, Valdez does cut around the eyes, and that's right. Always a possibility.
That's very true, especially the left eye. So we'll watch throughout the fight and see if anything happens.
Just a slight swelling around that left eye. Mendez, despite the punishment he has taken, seemingly is unmarked.
Yes, I don't see any marks on the man. And he's also still very game.
Woman has left. In round six. Valdez has his gloves very low, hasn't he, Ken?
He's carrying his gloves very low. I think he's getting a little bit more careless now. He's aware that he can take the man out with one shot if he can get that shot. And also, Mendez is the part that puts pressure.
Every so often, the man is a block.
Valdez is also not showing very much respect for Mendez at this point.
Mendez, a very good counterpuncher. His punches don't have the steam that Valdez does. About a minute to go here in round six. It is scheduled for 15 in Cali, Colombia. Referee Humberto Caceres has done a lot of counting so far.
Mendez's left eye is also swelling a little bit near the corner.
He's a good fighter, though, and he's taking the punishment again, but fighting back every so often.
That's very true, and when you two men stand toe-to-toe like this and throw all these heavy blows, this is when it's really grueling and when it's really tough, you have to be in shape.
Half a minute to go in the round. Those are hard, jolting punches by Valdez.
Very short, very stiff.
And a good one by Mendez.
Mendez is a very game individual. He's fighting back at all times.
Seconds to go.
Some people, they don't mean to waste.
Round seven before some 20,000 fans in the Coliseo del Pueblo in Cali, Colombia. And the challenger, who has been taking an awful beating, is suddenly carrying the fight for the champion. The challenger, Ramon Mendez, 28 years old from Argentina. The champion, Rodrigo Valdez from Cartagena, Colombia, in the lemon or light trunk.
The swelling around Mendez's eye is growing a little worse. There's definitely a lot of stiff punches from Valdez. It could be a telling fact later on in the fight, the swelling around the left eye.
Valdez himself has a slight swelling below the left eye. Mendez is making a contest of it, no question. He has stood up under the champion's punches, went down three times, but got up each time, and is still in there in round six, round seven. 2 minutes left in this round. He's fighting a smart fight, Ken. Mendez is.
Fighting a very smart fight.
And he's nailing Valdez on the way in now with pretty good right.
Very true. Now, the fact is, there's going to be one telling fact, is we hope that Valdez will not punch himself out.
I've noticed that Valdez is off the ground sometimes when he throws his left hook, not getting the power. Now he's got him in trouble again.
At the rate the fight is going now, Valdez is going to punch this man out of position. He's going to win the fight.
About a minute and 15 seconds to go in the round.
Okay, Valdez is slowly wearing his man down with heavy punches.
He is.
The question is if he's going to be able to last the full length of the 15 rounds, throwing so many punches so heavy.
A minute to go in this round. And now Valdez looks as though he's trying to measure him, and he's working the body a little bit more. He's trying to bring down that guard.
That's true. I'm sure that in between rounds that Gil Clancy told the man, go to the kidneys a little bit behind the elbows. Yeah. Try to get the man to drop his guard.
That right rocked him. And he's in trouble again. Mendez in real trouble with half a minute to go in the round. If he lasts this round, I'll be surprised. I've been surprised before. Round seven comes to a close.
Mendez is going to last this round.
He's still plenty of fight. He's covering up so much, though, he's hard to get a shot at now. He must be standing on nerve alone.
It was a very hard-going shot.
As they go back to their corners, Rodrigo Valdez is in the right-hand corner, and Ramon Mendez is in the left-hand corner. And even though Mendez has been down three times, he doesn't seem to show any signs of wear as he sits there. Rudy Escobar, the only man ever to knock out Ramon Mendez, Rodrigo Valdez in 1965, is standing there with the microphone. That is the only time Valdez ever was shot. We see Gil Clancy applying some water to his man on the right, and the manager of Ramon Mendez is working on him over on the left-hand side, Rico Agostino from Italy. About 5 seconds before the start of round number eight. Valdez always gets out there quickly, and here is round eight. Valdez in the light trunks, the lemon trunks. Mendez in the black trunks, the red border and stripes. We pass the halfway mark of this 15-round bout in Callejo del Pueblo.
If you notice at the start of every round, Mendez comes out, he applies the pressure. In the end, Valdez tends to wear him down with the stiff punches, and he's back to the same old groove as by the end of the round.
Well, Mendez will be dangerous. He has scored 28 knockouts.
That's true. He can be dangerous, but Valdez is showing less respect every round. He's starting to gain more confidence in his punching power and in how he can pinpoint his shots and land them almost at will where he wants on Mendez.
Also, Kenny's working the body now and working it hard. 2 minutes to go on this round.
If you'll notice, Mendez punches has nothing in them now. He just really punching him out there.
He's still trying, fighting a backing up fight, covering up, mostly on the rope, not giving Valdez a good shot at his chin. Valdez's most devastating punch has been the short right uppercut.
Valdez is slowly wearing his man down, throwing the heavy artillery, and it's a matter of time until Mendez just gives out, I think.
Mendez was down twice in the second round, once in the fifth round.
That's very true, and if you'll also notice that Mendez's left eye is almost swollen shut now.
Mendez is starting to get a little bit gun-shy. He's starting to wince as he takes the punishment. And he's just toying out with his punches now. A minute to go in the round. They go fast. 3 minute round. Valdez in charge all the way. The crowd senses the kill and they go to him. Mendez down and Valdez trips over him. The mandatory eight count again.
Mendez is trying to indicate a low blow, but I'm sure everyone knows
Mendez is bleeding from the mouth. Mendez bleeding from the mouth, down for the fourth time. almost a minute to go, and there goes Santos down again.
Don, also, I think that Mendez's nose is broken. It looks very, very bad.
He is wobbling. They may have to stop it. They may. No, he's letting him go on so far. He asked him if he wants to go on. Now it's all over. The winner by a knockout, Rodrigo Valdez, defending his World Council Middleweight Championship here in the Coliseo del Pueblo. There he is being congratulated by Gil Clancy's manager. And the ring is being stormed by police and spectators alike. It was an exciting fight, even though it was one-sided. Rocky Valdez has defended his world middleweight title, the World Boxing Council title, for the second time. He knocked out Grassi Antona in France last November, and he has knocked out the challenger, Ramon Mendez, now. In this fight, Valdez was up there all the way. The first round was even, but after that, it was all Valdez. This is Don Dunphy speaking from Cali, Colombia.